What is Sharia or Sharia law? Sharia is Islam's legal system. It is derived from the Quran, Islam's holy book, as well as the Sunnah and Hadith, the deeds and sayings of the Prophet Muhammad. Religious scholars may give rulings as guidance on a particular topic or question. In Arabic, Sharia literally means the clear, well-trodden path to water. Sharia acts as a code for living that all Muslims should adhere to, including prayers, fasting and donations to the poor. It aims to help Muslims understand how they should lead every aspect of their lives according to God's wishes. What does this mean in practice? Sharia can inform every aspect of daily life for a Muslim. On other areas of daily life where Muslims may turn to Sharia for guidance include family law, finance and business. How are rulings made? Like any legal system, Sharia is complex and its practice is entirely reliant on the quality and training of experts. Islamic jurists issue guidance and rulings. Guidance that is considered a formal legal ruling is called a fatwa. There are five different schools of Islamic law. There are four Sunni schools, Hanbali, Maliki, Shafi and Hanafi, and one Shia school, Ja'fari. The five schools differ in how literally they interpret the texts from which Sharia law is derived. Interpretation of Islamic law is also nuanced according to local culture and customs, which means Sharia may look quite different in different places. What are some of the tough punishments? Islamic scholars say Sharia is mainly a code of ethical conduct and about worship and charity, but a part of it deals with crime. Sharia law divides offenses into two general categories, had offenses, which are serious crimes with set penalties, and tazia crimes, where the punishment is left to the discretion of the judge. Had offenses include theft, which under the strictest interpretations of Sharia, can be punishable by amputating the offender's hand. There are many safeguards and a high burden of proof in the application of had penalties. But experts say that often doesn't happen in practice. Some countries where Islamic law is applied adopt or enforce such punishments for had offenses, and surveys have suggested attitudes of Muslims to harsh penalties for such offenses vary widely. Thank you.